illegal drugs and getting away with it has never been easier.
It's all thanks to a substance that's actually legal in Wisconsin that's helping people pass drug tests. WISN 12's Joyce Garbaciak investigates the product fooling employers and parents alike.
This was their senior pictures.
Of all of the pictures of her sons, this one has a special place in Tracy Jeske's heart.
It was a touching for me because it was an older brother that was kind of like, I'm going to watch out for you, but he couldn't do it.
Couldn't do it because 5 days after this picture was taken, younger brother Tyler would be dead of a heroin overdose.
I still can't believe that it was drugs.
Tyler Barris was 26, a college graduate, held down a job in construction.
He was a good kid. He was respectful. You asked him to do something, he did it.
He lived at home in Fredonia, saving to pay off his school loans. Jeske never suspected he used drugs.
I never found any drugs on him.
But the day he died, Ozaukee County detectives found something in his room they hadn't seen before.
A synthetic urine kit.
Synthetic urine, a chemical concoction that mimics the makeup of real urine, urine that is drug-free.
Apparently there's this market out there now for this type of way to mask your drug use and potentially beat a drug screening.
Tyler had to take routine drug tests because he operated heavy machinery at work.
I didn't know what it was.
Synthetic urine kits are available online. This one costs $45 plus shipping with a warning right on the box, not intended for unlawful use.
Nobody can give me a reason why you need synthetic urine unless you're trying to pass a drug test.
Ozaukee County's lead drug investigator told me in 34 years of law enforcement he had never come across this before Tyler's death. But he has since, and that's why he's talking now.
I think it's important for employers so that they have good procedures in place so that people can't have this type of product and beat their systems.
For Wisconsin-based Schneider Trucking, one of the largest trucking firms in the nation, it became apparent that just a urine sample from would-be drivers was not enough.
People that essentially have learned to beat the urine test.
Vice President Don Osterberg says the cottage industry online has learned how to make synthetic urine test very much like the real thing.
Congratulations, you have passed the test.
It is very much a game of cat and mouse.
So to stay one step ahead, Schneider tests its applicants and current drivers by requiring a hair sample along with urine, which is federally mandated. Hair testing shows a drug history, if there is one.
We generally will look for drug use in the past 90 days.
But doesn't show recent drug use. Still, Osterberg says for Schneider, testing hair as well is a good way to eliminate those who would try to drive impaired.
This is a senior picture, yeah.
For Tracy Jeske, it all boils down to one question.
Is there any reason why it would be legitimate?
Go online and there are many companies that sell it. Most come with the disclaimer, not intended for unlawful use. Plus, it comes in this nondescript packaging, Craig, so can be easy for parents to miss.
And many viewers tonight may even be surprised themselves that this is even possible.
A lot of people I spoke to had never heard of it before. I discovered it when I started doing a story on the prevalence of heroin and was looking into some recent court cases. This, for example, is the criminal complaint against the man prosecutors say sold the heroin to Tyler. And right here is mention of the synthetic urine kit that they found in Tyler's room.
Now, another part of your investigation here, of course, you found out a number of states have already looked at this and they've outlawed synthetic urine.
At least 11. And in our next half hour, I asked State Senator Alberta Darling how Wisconsin plans to address the issue.